Hello, Libra women. Welcome back to Will's Cartomancy Tarot. Ladies, what I like to do is to go on and give you your fertility and or adoption reading for this year, 2020. And ladies, this reading is valid until the end of this year. Ladies, I've decided to go on and just use my Lenormand's deck as already shuffled and illustrated as we see here. And also, I decided to go on and just select two additional cards from other oracle decks that I have that will give you a bit more part and advice into your situation. Ladies, I'd like you to go on and just give this a big thumbs up if it resonates and continue to share this with others, okay? And if you've yet to subscribe, please take a few moments to do so now. Okay, let's get started here looking at your cards and just making a few general observations. It looks like that you guys are, it seems to be very positive for you guys in terms of you conceiving or either adopting here. I'm feeling a very strong indication here as well as I've been seeing in a lot of you, the signs reading up. The possibility of you conceiving multiple embryos. I'm feeling that a lot of you have been struggling a lot to get pregnant. And I see that some news is on the way if you haven't already received it. I also see that positive change just seems to be coming up in your relationship with a rather, it looks to me, a rather immature type male. But I think that this might even lead to something more permanent if you're not already married, or it may even lead to marriage or even, in fact, a stronger commitment. Okay, let's go on and get started here and look at your card at the bottom. We have that path card. And it shows here that you probably hear something about this pregnancy if you haven't already heard, or even possibly an adoption. It looks like it could be possibly during an air type period. And of course, that's the ones that we have left here is Gemini as well as Libra. And we also have the earth period. I'm kind of getting here. We have the Taurus, you know, and or the Virgo that I'm kind of seeing that might be promising. For you guys, you know, because I kind of feel that it's going to happen this year. So this card is all about decisions and, you know, choices and options and, you know, alternative plans and even, ladies, second opinions. So I'm kind of feeling that you might be making a decision to kind of take a different course of treatment or change your medication that you've been taken, or even perhaps even for some of you change doctors. You know, I'm just seeing that you're going to have a lot of options, and perhaps you might be going out and trying to get like second opinions. But this card, it's certainly a strong indicator that you might in fact conceive twins with that card. Okay, so let's look at what you may have already experienced or what you might be in the process of experiencing here. We have that cross card there. And of course, this card is all about, you know, anxieties of all sorts, you know, guilt, you know, shame, various challenges just tend to crop up and suffering and being worried. You know, it's a feeling, ladies, that, you know, one has everything in the world, you know, or everyone else has everything in the world except you, a feeling, that type of feeling. So it shows that this card is rather tough. So it shows that a lot of you may have had some previous obstacles that may have gotten in your way of you conceiving. I'm kind of feeling here. But you have next here, you have that heart card, and that's more of a positive card. It's all about joy, happiness, and love and desire. So it shows that even though that you've been having these conflicts, you still have a very fervent or strong desire to conceive, okay? And you have confidence that this can, in fact, happen. And then next to that, you have the horse card, okay? And that card is all about, you know, news that tends to come in. And because it's like in your past, ladies, the news may have already come in, or it might be in the process of coming in soon, okay? And it shows perhaps a response to an inquiry of some sort, or it could be a response to this alternate path of treatment that you've decided to take to see what your results are would be, okay? I'm kind of feeling, but it's usually because you have the card that sits right next to it, it's good news. And next is your significator here, that child. So I'm going to go on and consolidate these cards, ladies, and just give you a story that you can understand. So many of you seem to have faced many challenges, ladies, and or obstacles. It seems that these obstacles, of course, in your pursuit to kind of conceive, and it appears that many of you either want to adopt or conceive. And in doing so, many of you might have already considered options or different options or different alternate paths to kind of get to where you would want to be, and might have decided upon, you know, even in vitro fertilization, or again, like I said, you know, various medication options. So I'm feeling that whatever it seems that you're doing, it seems like it's going to work, because you're going to soon receive news, as I've already indicated from here, this card, that you are, in fact, you know, you've conceived, you know, if you haven't already kind of received that news or this type of news yet, ladies, okay? So let's look at your future cards here. We have that man card. And ladies, this man can either represent the expectant father, or that's going to be kind of supporting you through this process, or he could be a doctor or a specialist of some sort that is going to be assisting you, or maybe even deliver the news to you that you are in fact pregnant. But with this gentleman that I see that you're dealing with, he might even be a bit immature, as I've already indicated from the onset. But your cards are showing that this connection that you may have with him is leading to a more stronger type, you know, commitment here that I'm seeing. And this symbol might also represent too a notification that you've in fact received information that you're pregnant here, because I'm combining this card along with that ring card, and that certainly is a symbol of fertility. Okay, it confirms fertility because it's all about an agreement. And notice here, ladies, this is a circle, okay? And so we're seeing this card, since it's a circle, it kind of shows you kind of getting, you know, ongoing treatment, and I feel it's going to be successful, and that success, as I said, is certainly indeed going to follow here. And then you have, last but not least, the birds there. So this again shows, further emphasizes the phone call or the information that you receive from your doctor notifying you that you are in fact pregnant. And it shows a possibility of you being pregnant with multiple embryos. But I'm kind of feeling that, ladies, some of you or many of you might be put on bed rest in some sense because of the possibility of you carrying, you know, more than one embryo. But I'm just seeing some of you being bedridden in some way, okay, which is neither negative or positive. It's just a part of the process of pregnancy. Okay, and I just wanted to just, you know, add these two additional cards just to give you a bit more parting advice here. And we have this, you know, Archangel Raziel, and what he's kind of suggesting to you is that, ladies, you might want to try to take your power back during this period, okay? Try to use your God-given power and kind of intentions and, you know, manifest the blessings that you like to come into your life. And in the process, use your clairsentience, okay? And that's what Archangel Raquel is trying to tell you. And what he wants you to do is to kind of notice your recurring, you know, physical and emotional feelings, because again, they are being divinely sent. So just follow what you know to be true to yourself. So Libra, this is what I have for you. I certainly hope that this reading has offered food for thought. I look forward to hearing your comments. And ladies, make sure that you subscribe as well as click the like button. Thanks a lot. Thank you.